I think the fact that the competition was brought to England is amazing for me. And for all these countries, guys from all over the world to come and experience English life and English culture is something that I feel very honoured and proud about. When we're going around, I get to they're always asking me questions, asking me what's this, what's that. I've took a few of the guys for fish and chips, and that was quite an experience. My preparations for the assault course were just to hit the gym. I also went on a Marines assault course, but nothing prepared me for how hard it actually was. I gave it my all, and I was at the emotional breaking point, to be honest with you. I made the final 12, which I was extremely proud of, and it was quite emotional for me to make that stage because it far exceeded my expectations.
Yes! Puerto Rico! Philippines!
At the D-Day landing celebrations, I was honoured to be one of the few chosen to go along to meet some of the war veterans and have conversations with them. It meant a lot to me because my grandfather was in the RAF. He was one of my best friends, and when we lost him a few years ago, that's something I really miss, talking to the older generation about their experiences.
I cry a river over you.
My profession is as a professional singer, so I definitely thought the talent part would be for me. I've got all my family coming, but the most important person that's coming for me is my grandmother, who's 97. I'm really happy that she can come because she's not well at the minute, she's got cancer. So the fact that she can come and watch me, especially if I was to make it to the talent final, fingers crossed, she'd be able to see me sing as well, which she hasn't been able to in years because of ill health. Yeah, there are only three places available to perform, and there's 14 of us in the talent final. So to get one of those golden three spots would mean a lot to me, just for the fact that my grandma would be able to watch me performing on the talent stage.
'Cause I cried a river.